Please prepare yourself for Dean Ted Ladd's spectacular graduation speech that concentrates all of my wisdom into a single nugget for the graduates of the Hult International Business School of San Francisco. Let me turn to my speech in the book. Where is it? This is embarrassing. Sandy?
Yeah?
Do you have my speech?
No.
Okay. I'm very sorry, but I think I have lost my speech. I think I left it on my desk back at campus. So if you'll bear with me, this would just take a few minutes. Could you just wait here? I will grab my phone. You can follow me as I rush back to campus. I'll use FaceTime. I'll be back in a second. Just wait.
When you told me you were leaving, put me down for a while, yeah. You know I could have been leaving, but a crap in my style, yeah.
Olaf, I lost my speech. Please, please help.
If you want to have a good future, you need to see the early signposts of change, shape them, and build the future that you want to see happen, for that is the way to prosperity and happiness.
I've seen Sam in the movies. He seems like an incredibly nice, funny guy. Sam, you got any advice?
Hey, Dean Ted. Oh, you lost your speech. Yeah, sure. I can just, like, off the top of my head, I can think of some things. I guess maybe you want to tell the graduates to, you know, use humor more often. You know, like sometimes, like, you know, only a pause, like an eye roll, can, you know, are enough to build, like, a human connection. So, I mean, I hope that helps. Does that help? Okay. Yeah. All right, I'll talk to you later. Yeah, call me anytime. All right. Bye. Good luck.
Priyanka, no speech. What do you got?
It's important to do good to others while doing great to yourself. Please take care of people and planet.
Who else? Gina Torres was in The Matrix and Serenity and Suits. She's got to have some good advice, too.
Hey, Dean Ted. How are you? I got a message from you. I got a bit of a crazed message from you. You lost your speech, the one that you were going to give to the graduates at Hult in San Francisco. Did you check all your pockets and your drawers? Maybe you left it in the car. Wish them health. Wish them strength, wish them love and adventures, and remind them to find the magic in every day. You think you got that? All right, I'm sure you'll find your script. Speech. I'm sure you'll find it. They'll be fine. They've had you. Congratulations.
Carrie, I lost my speech. You're an expert at this. What should I do instead?
I hope you'll take with you the two questions that have served me well in my career. What if and why not? Those are the questions that are at the heart of innovation and disruption, and I hope you'll be willing to use them when you step into those moments of leadership.
Wait a minute. Brian Cox was an actor in that TV show called Succession, which is all about money. Maybe Mr. Cox can give me some advice.
Hi, Dean Ted. Please tell graduates to act with courage, conviction, and even if they don't feel it, to form the world in the way they want.
Omar, I need some help. I lost my speech.
Our students from San Francisco should know how proud we are about your journey. Everything that you have achieved in the last 12 months that put you in this great position as change makers of this world.
Do you have advice for what I should say to these graduates?
My advice for you today is to hold on to those skills that you learned when you built the teams. Those soft skills will really help you grow in your career.
Matt Lilly, you're the president of Hult. You must have some good advice for my speech.
Hey, Ted. Two bits of advice for you today. First of all, make sure you iron your shirt. Second, right before you go on stage, check your teeth for food. You got this.
Thomas, remember about 1355 Sansom Street, about a place that was home for at least a year for you. And whenever you're in the neighborhood, just swing by and say hi.
Mom, can you help?
Oh, Ted, I'm so sorry you did that. But I'm still proud of you, and I'm proud of your sister, and I'm proud of those students who've been at it for so many years, and congratulations to them and good luck. And Ted, don't do it again.
Who else should I turn to? How about the governor of California? Governor Newsom? Mrs. Newsom?
His higher education system is world class. Mm-hmm. And as a graduate, by definition, you are on a path to success. The opportunities ahead of you are, well, they're immeasurable. And with this education, we hope you can, well, help shape the future for better.
You're a great professor. You're very analytical. I lost my speech. Don't yell at me right now. What should I say?
You have the drive, the energy, the skills, and now the network to do whatever you want to do in your career. I'll share something that's always served me well, and that is do what you love and you'll never work a day in your life.
Laura, as my wife, you know me best. What should I say to these graduates?
Oh, Teddy, tell them how much you love them. For every ounce of your heart that you have put towards this past year, the students, the staff, every person on the Hult campus has reflected back tenfold what you've put in with their own spirit, their own love, their own passion. This is such a celebration of that shared love and community that you have created together today. Don't forget to tell them you love them.
I was not able to find my speech. So all I can say is congratulations to the class of 2022.